What you gonna do?
What is the one quality that you possess that makes you think that you can walk out here and come into the ring and face the very best in the business?
Ruthless aggression.
That was the debut that started a legendary career. In a short time, the WWE lost two of the greatest superstars in history. Seeking a superstar who could lead the WWE into the future and beyond, Vince McMahon asked one question.
Who has enough ruthless aggression to reach for the stars as you never have before? Is that right?
John Cena answered the
question. Champ is here.
John Cena is a man of many things. A 16-time world champion, a doctor, a future Hall of Famer, and of course, the greatest prank the internet has ever seen. With his pending Hollywood stardom and quite possibly his final main roster run, we can comfortably say that John Cena is the greatest superstar to step foot in the WWE. Nobody can say that they were at the top longer. In the era of superstars consisting of JBL, Randy Orton, Batista, Daniel Bryan, CM Punk, and many more, no one had a run like John Cena. When the ratings were low.
For over a year, one of the all-time greats.
When WrestleMania season hit.
Throw some interruptions.
Well, you're the only.
Well, it's now called the AA.
As a throwback call.
When new superstars needed to go over.
Oh, my God.
Some of the most important moments in WWE history all revolve around John Cena. 16-time world champion. 5-time United States champion. 4-time tag team champion, 2-time Royal Rumble winner, and a host of other awards in the ring. He's one of the most accomplished in-ring competitors ever. Outside of the ring, John Cena is an absolute legend. A rapper, an actor, a host. He became the first celebrity to grant 300 wishes for the Make-A-Wish Foundation. He's been an advocate for many other organizations as well. Now, with all that being said, the criteria for him being the greatest superstar ever all boils down to one thing: longevity. He's gone toe-to-toe with virtually every major superstar of the last 20 years, and even The Rock in two once-in-a-lifetime events. Now, the knock on Cena has always been... Yeah, that's pretty accurate. No argument there. And the comebacks. Oh my God, I hate Super Cena. The man would get beat down the whole match and then come back and win.
Is it Reigns' moment? Oh! Cena! Reigns! Cover! Hook of the leg! And it's tank!
Well, maybe he didn't.
Perfect! Cover! Shoulders! Cena kicks out! John Cena with the AA! Oh, no! Hook from behind!
He got it! He got it! He got it!
KO by Cena! Hook of the leg! And Cena kicks out!
Fans got bored of seeing John Cena win every main event match, every title match, and every WrestleMania bout he took part in. Now, it doesn't help that WWE refused to change up Cena's character once he ditched the Doctor of Thuganomics gimmick, drawing comparisons even to Hulk Hogan in the 1990s. Hogan revived his wrestling career by turning heel and joining the New World Order in 1996. Had he stayed in the babyface Hulkamania gimmick forever, Hogan would have become irrelevant very quickly, and we all wanted Cena to do the same thing.
How about a little heel turn? You see, that's the excitement that I'm talking about!
But John Cena is a man of many principles, most notably hustle, loyalty, and respect. So he went back to the lab and continued to get better.
Cena gets Styles again! AA one more time!
John Cena was still delivering at the highest level. John Cena fed off the negativity and boos from the WWE Universe. He put the WWE on his back after losing two of the greatest superstars in the industry.
And you stand there and blame me. Fine, I blame you. I'm still here because you can't do your job.
He's carried the torch for almost two decades.
Keep it up, I'm a nigga.
He is the face that runs the place.
Because I can do this part-time better than you could ever do it full time.
He is John Cena, the greatest superstar in WWE history.
Tell me he didn't just say that to me.